Hi guys, Schooler here, and welcome to another episode of Trucking Diaries. If you remember, in the last episode, we brought some colour to Las Vegas. Yes, the trailer behind us, which says Sager or Sala on it or something, was apparently a load of colour, which we brought to 4-2 Print here in Las Vegas. So a quick look where we are. We are here in 4-2 Print in Las Vegas. So we're going to find a job out of here. Now, I think I mentioned in the last video, the W900 is released. The engine isn't great sounding, but there is a mod available, which gives a rather lovely engine sound. However, our money is not fantastic, 59,000, and the bank loan situation is not looking that great either, with $500,000 being owed. So we're due to make a payment very shortly, so that's going to come down another 5,700. The company manager is interesting. The drivers that we hired are starting to pick up, which, you know, give it another couple of days, I'm hoping they'll be on some decent money. But the long and short of it is that I need to work. I need to start getting some money in. So let's have a look at the job market. I don't think we're going to get the W900 just yet. I was planning on getting it level 10. I may get it earlier depending on the money situation, although at level 10 we unlock the sleeper cab. I'll be honest though, with the Kenny, the W900, I kind of like the day cab. I really do. But, you know, I guess we should go for the sleeper, even though it's got this redonkulously long wheelbase on it. But we'll see. I'll make the decision soon enough. Walmart. Nice. Where's that going? Down to San Diego. One going over to Oxnard. A couple of cars, some machine parts. Office supplies from 4-2 Print. That's where we are now. That is a San Miguel trailer. Pretty certain that San Miguel's a beer, not an office supply, which is interesting. 10k paying 1845 over to San Fran. 1845, we can do better. I think we'll take this. We've got to grab the money. I quite like the look of the Walmart trailer. It's going to look quite nice, I think, next to this truck. Let's start her up. Hopefully, the drive is not too long. Let's just put the daylights on. Let's get rid of that. What time of day is it, actually? It is 9:45 a.m., which is really annoying because my guy's going to be sleeping soon. Which means we're going to have to sleep him, probably this afternoon. Which is a bit annoying, because it means he's sleeping through the day. We're going to be doing a bit of an evening drive by the look of it, possibly into the night. Well, actually, definitely into the night. By the time we pick this thing up, we might be delivering the early hours of the morning. I had a look inside the Kenny anyway, the W900. Hello. Took your time there, pal. The W900's interior I do like, and unlike the stock Kenny that you get, it actually comes with quite a nice display. You can press the I key and it'll show you your digital speed, which I'm sure you know I kind of like. So I'm happy with that. I think I'll be happy in the Kenny, to be honest. Until at the least a very good Volvo VNL mod comes along. There is one out, but it's not fantastic yet. Still early days. I mean, this game's only been out a couple of weeks, so it's fine. But I'm kind of settling on either a W900 or VNL is what I'm thinking I'll drive for the longer term. But, you know, we do need to stop just changing trucks because every time we change trucks, it's going to cost money. I need to slow down. I don't want a ticket. Don't like tickets. Nasty tickets in this game. Hello, Mr. Yup. The poster up there, little billboard. The amazing. What does that say? The amazing what? Bronco Jellyneck. That's probably a show that I think I'll skip. I'm not really a fan of jellyneck people, you know. Don't like the idea of that. I can imagine the crowd sitting and going, ooh. Whoa, red leather or what? Look at that car. A grey car. Imagine that, a grey car. He's like, you know what? I'm gonna keep the colour nice and muted. Just grey for me. Okay, sir, and what colour leather would you like on the interior? Oh, bright red. Bright red interior, yeah. You know, not blood red, bright red. That's what I want to do. Oreos! No way! Come back! You want a race, bro? Oh, man. Fail? Never, ever, ever ask somebody to want to race at lights and install it, because that is pretty much the worst thing you can do right there. That's nice. You see, when I grow up, I'm going to be a truck like you. Man, that thing's huge. Look at the state of it. It's just enormous. Nice colour. I like the blue. I'll probably go for something a bit darker myself. It's a bit of a baby blue, that one. But it's not bad. Oh, man, you're in my way. I need to be in that lane now. Are you kidding me? Okay, is there a cop around? Nope. Oh, look at that! And he wanted to switch lanes. Amazing. The irony, right there. I always find the roads in Las Vegas just enormously intimidating. Just so many lanes, it's so easy to get in the wrong lane. I think I read on an SCS blog that they're actually adding more speed, like speed limit signs, you know what I mean? Because as we've noted in this series, you're driving along and you don't know when the speed limit change is coming very well, it just happens. I think they're going back over the map and adding speed limit signs. Which is very much needed. I don't get this. Why am I being allowed to go? This is weird. That's not how it's supposed to work! Right, I think we're here. Where is it? Whey! I think that was at the Walmart trailer at the back there, possibly. He says mounting the curb. Yay! And look at that, Walbert, and then a Walmart trailer. That's fantastic. It's got to be one of those, isn't it? Okay. San Diego, 10 grand. Not a lot of money, but it'll pay this month's loan payment. Sorry, today's loan payment. Imagine having a loan where the payment is almost $6,000 per day. Like, what? $6,000 per day? Now, I'll put that mirror on because I know a bunch of you like that mirror. He says with his tongue in his cheek. There we go. Reality broken. Look, that is... Oh, you see, if I had the horrible-looking roof spoiler, that would look beautiful. But I'll be honest with you, I don't like the roof spoiler. I think it looks horrid. But I'm happy. It's all black. It looks good. Morning, Jeff! Yeah, chatty as ever. Right turn... Clear this side. Let's go. Oh, the truck handles so much better when there's a trailer on the back. I really hate it when it's trailerless. It's just so lightweight. Okay. No idea where you are. There you are. Right, let's get out of Vegas. I do like Vegas in this game, but... Like I said, there's a couple of things about it. Firstly, the road system is pretty nasty, to be honest. There's so many lanes, there's so many intersections. I mean, look at the size of this intersection. It's just enormous. So I find that a little bit intimidating. But worse than that, because it is such a detailed city, there are so many details that the frame rate does take a bit of a tank. Nothing nasty, just it's noticeable, you know? Cabaret de Lune. Hang on, Cabaret de Lune, is that like... The Moon Cabaret? Lune. Sounds like Luna. Moon Cabaret, maybe? Not really sure. Hey! Isn't that like a Ford... Is that a Ford Ka? What is that? I don't know if they had those in the States. Maybe it's the equivalent. I can't see the badge on it properly. I don't know, it looks like a Ford Cat in the UK. I do like these little sculptures though in Vegas. Those things. They're so cool. Right. Ooh, clear. Nice. So that's a semi-decent run-on ramp. That's not too bad. California State Prim. Let's go. Some people have been posting screenshots that they've managed to lift out of the game. It's quite funny. I think there's one that I saw where you can see, obviously, California and Nevada. And then you can see about four states all around it that... it looks like it looks like SCS has kind of marked them as if they're going to get worked on next. You know what I mean? So there's a big debate now as to what's going to be the next one after Arizona, which is quite amusing because nobody really knows what's going to be the one after Arizona. But they're going to have to build in some direction, either north towards Canada or start going east. There's a bit of a debate going on. You're going to move over in a second. I know you are. I don't like this guy just hanging here. Office space available. Dude, why am I catching you up? I'm only doing like 60. Those things can go quite quickly. Definitely quicker than this. Uh-oh, city limits. That's okay, 65. I do find myself guessing at what the speed limit might be because they're not posted. Okay, this is awkward. I'm sorry, I'm not, you know, I'm not slowing down for you. You should probably slow down and get behind me. I've got some fresh produce to deliver, you know. Fresh veg and meat and stuff. Actually, what? It could be anything in here. Walmart sells everything. What did it say it was? Oh, household appliances. I take it all back. I've got toasters and dishwashers and stuff. Oh no, the loan payment hype. What? Wait, what? Who just changed the speed limit to 55 on me? You scumbag. Oh my god, it was like 1865 and then it became 55. Right when I had a screen over it. Ah! How much did I get fined? I didn't actually spot that because they changed it, didn't they? They tweaked how much you get fined at lower levels. I don't think it was as much. Oh man. And yes, I know you can turn it off with a mod. You can even turn it off in the options now if you want to. You can just turn it off. They did a patch where you've got an option to turn off tickets from speeding fines because they know how much people hate it. So they put this option in the game and said, oh, you just turn it off now. You don't like it, but I'm not doing it. I'm leaving it on. I'm not saying I like it, it's more realism. I shouldn't have been speeding. I should have spotted this sign. That's fine. I'm the driver here. Balloon hype! Love it. Kingsman and Flagstaff, right turn, okay. Okay, here we go. Route 40. Yeah, I'd like to get a proper working freight train mod as well, one that doesn't do stupid things. It just gives us nice long trains. But I don't know if the one that I saw has been fixed yet. I don't like the idea of floating trains in a video, do you? But maybe when it's working, I'll definitely get that one enabled. Or maybe somebody from SCS watches the video and goes, hey, you know what? Squirrel's right. We should actually just put long trains in this, because that's what they do in America with freight trains. They have nice long trains. Let's just do that. Ah, I've been past this before. Wow, would help if I knew what gear I was in. Yeah, that, there's like a vehicle on top of it. It's some kind of... I think it's, what do you call it? A landfill, that's what I was looking for. Like a landfill, but it's a giant mound, I think. I think that's what it is. I'm not 100% sure, if I'm honest. I know that guy... He's got nerves of steel, just sitting up there. In his vehicle. I reckon he built that thing, and then he was up there and he went... So how do we get down from here? Did we work that bit out? Slow that down a bit. I love this. It's like a winding, descending road. With a... like a camber on the road so that it banks in, which is lovely. Obviously, 40 miles per hour, they obviously feel that you shouldn't be racing down here, which is obviously the temptation, because it is quite steep, to be fair. Like, the momentum on the truck just picks up massively. There's so many behind. The wind farm. How far have we got? 257 miles. Actually, you know what? I don't know if I've done that road going the other way. The uphill version of that would be interesting. Actually, I think I have. I think I've done it once. It's actually a very steep hill. When you've got a heavy weight and you're going up there, it's very, very noticeable. It's a bit of an illusion, that hill. Oh my life, did you see that motorcyclist then, when he came around the bend? He didn't even lean over, he just stayed up vertical and came around. Wish I knew you were turning right earlier. Well, somebody turned on rush hour. Okay, that's two turning right, I can make that. Forgot about that. The guy's getting tired. Meant to hit ninth gear then. Rest stop in 2 hours. What's the ETA on the job? Expected. Sunday 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. We've got another 6 hours of driving left. Okay, we are going to have to take a rest. Which means... an early morning hours delivery. That's okay, we'll just enjoy this lovely, lovely desert drive. How many miles have I done on my truck? 3,000? Oh, I'm just coming up for 4K. Nice. I remember when I did this, did it on a stream, I think it was. We got to about 13,000 miles on the truck before I handed it in. That was pretty cool. I quite like the idea, though, of doing 100K on my truck. Maybe not on this one, but... one that I feel like I've chosen, because at the moment, the Peterbilt and Stock Kenny are just like, meh. They're alright, but... I kind of feel like I want a good truck, you know? I just saw that guy braking in the outside lane there. I thought there was going to be a speed limit change, but it was just a left. Oh no! Here's me just watching that guy, not realizing I should have gone that way. Great. Okay, now we've got to turn around. Can we turn around at this junction here? No, it doesn't look like we can. It kind of looks like it loops back on its... It just turns right. Yeah, if we go that way... I'll have to go here. Actually, we'll go here and rest up. That's fine. It's not so bad. We'll lose a little bit of time. Yeah, I was obsessed with that guy because all I was looking at was his brake lights, and that took my eyes off the sat nav. And then didn't realize I was turning left. I wish I could zoom the sat nav. I know you can zoom this one, like that, yeah, and this, but why is there not a key press for the built-in sat nav to change the view on that one? Please don't pull out. Just don't, bro. Seriously, don't. I thought I said don't. Just wow. Uh-oh. I was speeding through that latter section because that guy kind of distracted me. It wants me to go left now. Is that a viable route, I wonder? Actually, it is. That's a perfectly viable... Oh, look at this. Look at this. Do you know what? Can I actually get down there and rest? I think I can. All right. Now the only problem I've got is to get in the left lane. I'm going to go that way. Okay, we got lucky with that one. That little, forgetting to turn off... stop! ...has paid off, actually, because that is a better route. We get to discover something. Probably a driver agency. Actually, where are we in the world? Actually, you know what? I've got a feeling that's a Kenworth dealer. If that's a Kenny dealer, we've got to go in and have a quick look. Have a quick sniff. Let's put temptation in the way, shall we? Let's see what happens here. Nice trailer. Repsol. Oh, my guy's getting tired. The only problem is the truck dealer will close soon. Ah, we may just end up with a lot of bad timing here. Fate may stand in the way. Because by the time we get there, this place is going to be closed. It being, what, 4:48? Yeah, I don't think we're going to make it. I think they're closed at 6. Times are ticking. Oh, this is not helping. Come on! There's nothing moving! This makes no sense! I want to get down to the Kenny dealer. Go shopping! That makes no sense, that trailer, with that kind of cab. Excuse me? Pretty certain I have right of way right there. The kind of people you have to put up with on the road. Okay, doesn't like 8th, let's try 7th. I wouldn't be so annoyed by that yawn if it actually changed a little bit. But it's the same audio played every, like, minute. The exact same audio. As if the guy can just yawn like that every single time. And he always goes, and then he goes, at the end. And it's just that little, just do something different. Nice cars. Right. Straight across here. Get onto the freeway. Whoa, really? The kind of nonsense I'm putting up with here. Some people might say, yep, that's pretty authentic driving right there. Okay, so it's on here, then we get off, and that's outside the Kenny dealer. I can't remember if it closes at 5 or 6. If it's 6 o'clock, then we'll make it. If it's 5, we've missed it. But I need to go there before we rest. Case in point. I'm sure it's a Kenny dealer. I am going off memory, though. I might be completely wrong. Probably get there and be like, oh, yeah, it's a driver agency. No! Oh, God. Oh! It's a Kenny dealer! Confirmed! Oh, come on, let's get out of here. Uh-oh. Hill start is not the best in this truck. Come on, mate. Oh, look at this. This game is conspiring. Let's go, let's go. It's all clear. It's good. Budweiser. Thank you. Much obliged. Please be open. Please be open. Turn it up in your Peterbilt to the Kenny dealer. Yay, they're open. Right. How much is a traded on that? You'll pay 26k. We have 56. Okay, hang on. Let's have a quick customize here. Let's have a little play, shall we? I don't know where this is going. Additional price. It doesn't tell me the trading price here. Ah, now look at this. Yeah, this shouldn't be available right now. So the mod that brings in the different engine audio that I've enabled looks like it didn't pay any attention to the unlock level, so it gives you everything. However, price is very much a factor. Like if I click that, it's going to be quite a bit of money. How much is that in total? 35 grand. Oh, I'm going to bankrupt myself doing this. Hang on. What do I want? Do I want a cat? Detroit diesel? Actually, I don't think some of them are... I can't remember which ones are enabled. Eek. I think some of the audios have not been done, but I can't remember which ones. Probably want to go for like a 400 engine or something. Or maybe a 6, just to be... A Cummins 600 for 35 grand. Pretty certain that's out of my driver bracket. Detroit diesel 425. 500 would be nice. That'd do us for a good while, that would. But a Caterpillar 500, maybe go with that. 2,500 torque, that's a lot of torque. Okay, 10-speed retarder, let's go with that. It's fine. Now, Score Logistics mod has been updated, and it does work for the Kenny now. Look at this. It's beautiful. If you have the sleeper as well, it has the Squirrel logo on the back. And again, if you want that, mod spreadsheet. How much is this costing? Wait a second before I start accessorizing. 37 grand we're up to. You know I'm going to hit the buy button. You know it's going to happen. Oh my God, what am I doing? I'm going to end up bankrupt. Stop clicking things. Stop it. Stop it. Why you do this? Oh, 11, level 11 for the filters. No, we'll go single mirrors, better frame rates. Standard sun shield. That looks pretty good, actually. Yeah, we'll go for the roof cabs there. Fender guards, oh, they look nice. Extra 250. Don't want that deflector. Don't want the mirrors. Oh, why? This looks silly with the holes in it. 2 grand. Look at that, just to get rid of the holes. What's all that about? If you'd actually allow me to put some lights here, I would. The modern bumper. Let's go with the modern bumper. There's not the stupid holes in it. Oh, yeah, we've got to have that. We've got to have the standard exhaust. I like that. Now, the big question is, do we go with black trims or white here? On the one hand, you've got the contrast. And on the other hand, you've just got the meme machine, all black. I'm going to go black. I think the white ones look nice contrast-wise. Oh my god. Why am I doing this? How much is this? 45,000 out of my 56. I've got to be crazy. I've got to be absolutely crazy to do this. Considering it's costing me $6,000 a day just for one... I'm going to end up broke, aren't I? If I buy this, I'm going to be broke. This job's only bringing in 10K. That's only like a day and a half's worth of loan payment. Why did I press this? We are sorry, but it takes a while to process a new purchase and don't want to hold you up while you're working. Please come back. No! No! You scumbag game! That feature was never in Eurotruck. No! But my perfect truck, how can you do this to me? I can't even save the configuration and buy it later. I've got to come back and... Oh, man. Okay, the game has spoken. Are you sure you want to leave? No, I want to trade in. But you won't let me. Right, that answers that question. So we're not doing that today. Wow, I can't believe they did that. I can't believe... SCS, I can't believe you fixed that on me. How dare you implement that feature? You just ruined my day. Right, where are we parking? Parking to the right there. So we're not doing that today. Which I wanted to. But at least you know how much it will cost. To be honest, it's probably for the better. But the disappointment is on my face right now. There we go. We'll just we'll take up two spaces because I hate you. I hate you, Kenworth. Even though I'll be back to buy a truck right now, I hate you, okay? Yeah, so in protest, we're going to take up two spaces. Good night. 4 a.m. This is my favorite bit. I like this here. When you start it up, you get that, and then listen to this. And if you actually watch a video of the Peterbilt starting up, it does sound like that. It's pretty cool. Let's get rid of this. I'm not going to repair the truck because we're probably going to trade it in, so we'll leave it. It's only got a few percent wear and tear on it. Okay, let's finish this job, get another 10k because it is now 4 a.m. That is the weirdest thing. Right there. I actually thought he was going to hit me then. That's the thing about the AIs, even though they've got loads of room on the road, I don't know, if SCS kind of, instead of just giving the vehicles a line, if you like, to go down, like a route line, if they actually made the line a little bit wider and just said, you can go down this route, and then, you know, anywhere in this width space, so you can move a bit left and a bit right. So, if you like, rather than drawing a line with a pencil, you draw a line with a brush. So it's like a thick line. And then the game engine can just go, oh yeah, I can just move anywhere in between this. So in that case, where I came out of there, it could have just moved over a bit to the right. That would have been pretty cool. Right, it looks like a dawn delivery. It's 142 miles. Yeah, should be nice. I could have been doing this in a new Kenworth, but Celavi. Can't believe that. The thing is, right, why did it not say that on the way into the screen? Like, you go to the Kenworth dealer, you go, enter the Kenworth shop, it shows you a load of trucks. And then instead of saying to you, by the way, you know, in red letters at the top, by the way, you're doing a job, so you can't buy this yet. You can't trade this in or purchase it. Instead, you sit there going, what if I put these mirrors on and this paint scheme? Nope, let me try something else. And you sit there. You could have been there for ages doing that. And then it goes, sorry, you're on a job. You can't buy it. Lol. Instead of doing that, it could have told you up front. But the actual ability to save a configuration would be very, very cool. I could have just window shopped then, said, because you can do that in real life, you know, when you buy a vehicle. You can do exactly that. You can go on websites these days, buying a car or whatever. You can sit there, choose the car, you know, put all the trim levels in there, get the engine, the paint, just everything. And then go save configuration. And then, you know, when your wife gets back from work, you can bring up your little tablet and just go, hey, look at this. What are you looking at cars for? Well, look at this configuration. Oh, that looks nice. That's how you do it, you see. And then when you walk into the dealer, you just go, hey, I want this. But for some reason, we can't do that. We have to go back later and just completely reconfigure the truck. Never mind, it's a lovely day. That was yesterday. Today is a new day. Today is a new loan payment. How much again? 10k for this? 10.5k? I need to get rid of them loans. Oh, my life. What I actually need is for my drivers to skill up really quickly. Like, they've got to start pulling their weight in monetary terms and not just in trailer terms. Once that happens, we'll be in a much better position. These boards on the right, are they soundproofing? What's over there then? Nothing. That's weird. When you see boards like that, it's usually for one or two reasons. Either they're blocking your view from something so you don't see something, or it's a sound barrier, but I couldn't actually see anything. I'll tell you what though, that train was going over there then. It was like it was going over the floodplains. I need to keep my eye on the road. I'm absolutely all over the road. Okay, I think we're nearly here. Just past this town. Yep. Coming through Carlsbad, down towards San Diego. Hi, Mr. Cop. No ticket for me today, no? Since they implemented that patch that reduces the fees of a ticket, imagine how much money I would now have. Because I've been fined at the full, what was it, 1,000, sometimes 1,400. If a cop sees you jump a red light, I think it was 1,400. Like, if I added up all those tickets at the reduced rate, I'd have been quids in, I think. That's a nice skyline view, I like that. And it looks like it's on fire, you see all the smoke? I assume that's water. I don't know what it is. Just like some steam, like mist effect. Okay, how are we looking here? It's a question for real truck drivers. You know when they approach those stop signs like that? And if you look left, there's absolutely nothing coming. Do you still stop anyway in a truck? Or do you say, that's just going to kill all of my momentum, so, and there's nothing coming, it's safe, so let's just go. But I'm guessing a cop sees you do it and you didn't stop, you probably get a ticket for it. So my guess would be, hello. My guess would be that you do stop anyway, but it must be really annoying in a truck. It's not so bad in a car with automatic, but in a truck. You know, just keeping that momentum going is very useful. Okay, we're parking next to the Twitch trailer. No, what is this? What is that? Is that a burrito? Taco. Taco Bell. Let's try and get all the way over here into the corner without knocking over all the pallets. Now then, can we actually make this? It looks a bit tight to me. Get it to rotate on the spot a little bit. Clearance is okay that side. Okay, that's not so bad. Trying to watch the line of the back wheel of the trailer there. Is that going to ding for me? It should do. There we go. That's not straight. Your customer expects delivery. Make sure you arrive on time. The customer's probably looking out of his window going, oh, it's all right, sir. Somebody wants to buy toasters in a hurry. There you go. See, that's straight. Now you can unload safely. You'll thank me later. Should be on time, hopefully. Excelente! 430 miles, 22 hours. Fuel consumed 60 gallons of fuel. Bonus trailer. Oh, look at the bonuses. Look at that. Beautiful. Pushed us on to just over halfway on level 8. 10.5k. Let's have a quick look at how our drivers are doing. Okay, that's good. They're up to $500 now. Nice. He needs to get another point in long distance, and so does he. And then the money will really start to pick up. Let's have a look where we are in the world. Okay, we are here. So we may get a job out of here. There may be some jobs over there we can do. Let's go back to the entrance. But it was safely delivered. Zero damage. We got one ticket, which was when the speed limit changed on the freeway. And I didn't spot that because I had the pop-up thing up. But other than that, it was a pretty good delivery. Lights off, engine off. Just wondering what them two were doing. Okay, so we just delivered Walmart household appliances to Walbert. That's it for this episode, guys. Until the next one, take care. Happy trucking.